As we explore quantum body, quantum universe, quantum mind, and beyond, and since our current science is based on matter as the ontological primitive of the universe, which means we start with matter and build up from there, everything, stars, galaxies, atoms, molecules, force fields, and everything that we call the physical world, since our technology and science is based on the presumption that matter is what begins the whole story of existence, including the nature of mind and emotions and imagination and introspection and reflective self-inquiry, that all is the dance of molecules. I remember being in St. Petersburg a long time ago at the museum, looking at some of the most amazing art that I had ever seen. And I was standing right next to Watson, the scientist who discovered DNA along with Crick. And I looked at one of the pieces of art. I said, all that is a product of physical matter, those beautiful paintings that evoke these emotions. And I remember Dr. Watson looking at me almost with disdain. He said, what else? And then he walked away. So bottom line, he, Craig, and who actually posed what is called the astonishing hypothesis, and all modern scientists believe that matter is what explains everything. So I think it's important to understand what is matter, after all. What is matter? How does science look at what we call matter? So in classical physics, which goes back to Newton, matter is generally defined as anything that occupies space and has mass. So your body is matter, it occupies space, it has mass, and it's the property of an object that resists acceleration, determines the gravitational attraction. This definition encompasses solid, liquid, and gaseous matter, which are different states of matter. Never mind that there's another state of matter called the vacuum. Okay, so coming to that, modern physics, in modern physics, the understanding of matter expands beyond just mass. Einstein's mass is equal to energy equivalence showed that mass and energy are interchangeable, blurring the distinction between them. Additionally, there are particles with zero mass, which means they don't occupy any location in space. And these are photons, and they're still considered part of the universe's energy content and play crucial roles to various interactions. So, from the classical perspective, matter always needs to have mass. From the modern perspective, it's more nuanced. Particles like photons have zero mass but are still considered fundamental entities interacting with other forms of matter and energy. They contribute to the overall energy mass content of the universe, even though they lack mass individually. So, then, of course, today science identifies dark matter, dark energy, which are hypothetical entities. And the nature of these is not really understood. But if they exist, their nature and relationship to the concept of matter and matter could further broaden our definition. So advanced fields like quantum mechanics delve deeper, like the energy of particles and energy, deeper into the energy of particles and the nature of particles and the nature of energy into nature of information, introducing non-intuitive concepts that challenge our classical notions of matter. So is matter material or is it non-material? That's the essential question. Now, at the level of the electromagnetic field, which we are using right now to engage in this monologue, rather, I wish it was a dialogue, but we're using the electromagnetic field. So, at the level of the electromagnetic field, matter is equal to energy, and that's being used right now to transmit this information. So, matter is equal to energy, but also information. And that's the electromagnetic field. But what about the quantum field, which is actually gives rise to the electromagnetic field through certain interactions of particles? The quantum field actually has no form at all, okay, and cannot be said, strictly speaking, to be in space-time. And the quantum field is that field from which virtual particles appear impermanently as determined by the uncertainty principle. And somehow these, kind of coalesce and interact. And there's all this new talk about the Higgs boson. Notwithstanding, we don't know most of the nature of the universe is not physical, as I've said before. 0.01% of the visible universe is available to us, and it is available to us as cosmic wave radiation that we then translate into what that would mean as the experience of what we call the physical universe: stars, galaxies, rocks, you, me, trees, and animals, and everything that we call physical. That begins with the quantum field, okay? And that quantum field is the source of the ephemeral, transient, ungraspable virtual particles, which are actually manifestations of the field which give rise to the physical universe. And that quantum field is even deeper than the electromagnetic field and pervades all of space-time, including your body, your brain, everything that is physical, including your body. And therefore, your mind, your body mind can't be separated. They're one unified process in the quantum field. So now we are getting to a level where matter starts to disappear into what is called non-matter, energy, and then information, and finally just possibilities. And those possibilities exist only in formless awareness. So as we look at the nature of the physical world, it becomes non-physical. If we look at the nature of the material world, it becomes non-material. We realize that the essential stuff of the universe is non-stuff. And now we are realizing that it is a kind of a thinking non-stuff, a cosmic mind, so to speak. And the human mind is actually one particular tributary of that cosmic mind, especially when we go beyond constructs. And then we realize that what we call physical matter is what we experience through in the waking state of consciousness. And these days, with sophisticated instruments that take us to the edge of the non-physical. Okay, and that everything from photons to electromagnetic fields to gravity to space-time to even the human body and the brain, everything is awareness knowing itself as that, tattvamasi. Awareness knows itself. And these are modes of experience. The way you experience gravity is another mode of experience in the human mind, which is an offshoot of the cosmic mind. So what we observe is gravity, a mode of knowing. What we call a Higgs boson, a mode of knowing. What we call an electron, photon, a mode of knowing. What we call physical matter, mode of knowing. There are only modes of knowing that we interpret as mass, weight, energy, information. But these modes of knowing are awareness itself. Awareness knows itself as the appearance of the physical world, appearance of the physical world. And that awareness is non-local. It's not a property of you and me. In fact, you and me as body minds are modes of knowing in the non-local awareness, which has infinite modes of knowing. And so Once we accept this hypothesis that the essential nature of the material world is non-material, that the essential stuff of the universe is non-stuff, that it's a kind of thinking non-stuff, a consciousness field non-stuff, then we'll have a new science. And that new science will explore the creation of new forms of matter through new forms or modes of knowing. Or we're already doing it with VR and Web3. We're extending the virtual reality we're in to a broader range of experience. So overthrowing the superstition of matter and realizing that what we call matter is conceived, constructed, governed, comes into existence in non-local awareness, and that we are that, that will lead to the creation of new forms of matter, even exotic forms of matter, and extend our the ability of our science and technology to create new worlds. And it is beginning right now. It's already happening with AI and Web3 and the virtual reality techniques. But always remember, your physical body and mind are also part of the virtual reality. The only one subject of all modes of knowing is infinite being. And actually, beyond the constructs, we are that. Aham Brahmasmi and Tattvamasi. Let me know if this made any sense to you.